Hello and welcome back to my channel. So if you are a new subscriber, thanks for subscribing to my channel. And if you are an old subscriber, also thanks for subscribing to my channel. So recently I've taken up a challenge called 100 days of code on Twitter in order for me to improve on myself and gain more knowledge, because actually I created this channel just to share what I think I know and not share what others have done, something like that. So I'm going to be taking a break until the challenge is complete. By then I'm sure I should have a lot to share with you guys. So that'll be it. I'm sorry for interrupting this video with this message. So it's just a quick message, and now let's go to the code. Good day everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today's video will be about a password input design I made. We'll be making it together. We have already made it though. So it's like just like your phone, where you could input your password, then it unlocks. But mine doesn't unlock. Mine just says welcome, congratulations. So as you can see here, we have this design. Okay, so let me uncomment this. So it shows that okay, your password is 2456. Then you click on the okay. Then let's try inputting something that is wrong and okay. Then it says incorrect password. Then you say 2456. Then 6. Okay. Then it says welcome, correct password. Yay! So this is what we'll be doing. Actually, this is it here. Then from this, we'll be implementing it in this font design. So if you've not watched my last video, you should check that out in order for you to be able to know how I did this font design, because I'm not going to be going over it again. So moving on to the code. So yeah, I basically have my HTML boilerplate. So I have my doc type, all this regular stuff that comes with HTML. Then I have a link linking the HTML file to my CSS file. Then I also have a script file. You might be wondering what defer means. Defer just simply is saying that you should load the script when the DOM content has loaded. So if you should read all this, it should explain that for you. So my HTML is simple because I only have just about roughly 12 lines. So I have a div with a class of container. Then I have my h1 saying enter pin, then my p having an id which is saying your pin contains at least 4 digits, then the inputs, then my buttons, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and so on, clear, so and okay. So that is basically all I have on my HTML page. Moving on to CSS. Well, for this video I'm going to be using Sass. I just love using Sass. It's just a CSS preprocessor which allows nexting. I don't think I'm pronouncing the word well. Nexting. Anyway, moving on. So all this is to get rid of the browser default padding, margin and box sizing. So moving on to my body selector. So I'm saying font family Montserrat, which is my favorite font. So I'm saying display flex, justify content center, align items, flex end. So this is what is moving this this container down. So if I should say center, now it's at the middle. So let's go back. I'm just going to comment this back. Okay, so I've said my the height should be 100 UH, which simply allows me to which is taking the whole page of the browser 100 view heights. Just the complete suite of the browser. So if I should do something like this, it's always going to be 100 view height no matter what. Okay, I hope you get that. If you don't get, just comment below. So I also have my background, so I'm saying the background should take this color, because you can't see the background now because I'm hiding it with the picture. So if I should remove the height so you can see this space here. So now I uncomment that. So I'm saying the background should be this, then the URL, which is, I don't know the full meaning, but for the browser, URL should be uniform resource locator, but on with CSS, I don't know, but it's a way of adding images. So this image is already on in my file here, in my folder. So I'm just grabbing it, adding it to the web page. So I'm also saying no repeat. I don't want the image to keep repeating itself. So I'm saying background size should be cover. I want the background to cover everywhere, the image to cover everywhere. So the background position should be center. So horizontally centered and vertically centered. And I'm saying the colored text color should be white. So now I'm moving on to my the container selector, which I've targeted. So I'm saying the background should be this color, which is this dark gray color there. I'm saying padding 2 AM, and I'm saying text align center. So I want everything to be at the middle of my container. So H1P and my input. So I'm targeting these three tags with my CSS, and I'm saying the margin. So I'm saying top and bottom. So 0.5 AM is the top, so top and bottom should be 0.5 AM, left and right should be 0. So now I'm targeting my input selector. I'm saying the width should be 100%, so 100% of the container. I remember I've given the container a padding of 2 AM. So I'm saying border videos 20 pixels, border none. The background should be white. I also want the text align to be center. So whenever I input things, it should be at the middle of the input selector or the input tag. So now I'm targeting my buttons. So I'm saying display flex wrap. Flex wrap is just if I should comment this out. Yep, you can see that. So it's long and I don't know that. So flex wrap helps the flex item like wrap together. So I'm saying the width of 100%, the max width should be 350 pixels. So I played with this to get the max width. So I'm saying okay, don't go above 350 pixels. So when you get to 350 pixels, stop going. So that is basically what I'm saying by using the max width. And I'm saying margin top and bottom should be 0, left and right should be auto. So it should always be at the middle of the container. So for each button, I'm saying display inline block, the width of 20 pixels, minimum height should be 100 pixels. Okay, when you get to 100 pixels, stop going. So the background should be none. Then I don't know why I have this. Then I'm saying margin top and bottom should be 2.2 AM, left and right should be auto, then color should be white. And this, well, you don't need this. I just did this for the phone, which I'm getting back into. Moving on to JavaScript section. So I'm saying my password for this design here is 2456. I could change it manually, but anyway, I'll just leave it that like that. So the password is 2456. Then I'm saying okay, let input equals to document.query selector input. So I'm targeting my input tag in my HTML page. So notice that I'm not adding semicolon, because in JavaScript you may choose not to add semicolon, but note the interpreter adds semicolon on its own before translating into the browser. So it's your choice. You don't need to add semicolons anymore. So I'm targeting my inputs. I'm also targeting the change. So the change is this P. I could have come up with a better name, but I gave change. So don't worry, we'll see what that will be changing to. So now I'm targeting all my buttons. So buttons, select buttons equals to document.query selector all. So assuming I had said query selector, it would have only picked the first button, but because I wanted to select all my buttons, so I said query selector all. So this would take all my buttons. So I'm saying let's delete. So delete to be this clear. So the clear button is delete. So let's delete a down equals to document.query selector hashtag delete. So even the okay, I also got the okay ID. So now I have the buttons, which is this. So I'm targeting all the buttons. Then I have a for each method. If you've not used for each method, it's just you can target each individual button using the for each method. So it is really complicated at first, but if you use it, you'd be able to understand it more. So I'm saying for each button, then there's a function here. So this is our function for each button. Now the button add an event listener, whereas when there's a click, then this function should be run. So basically what is here is that all the buttons are targeted. Now for each button, that button should have an event listener that listens to a click, then it has this callback or function. So now the function is saying, I don't know why I give it that name, should have come up with a better name. So the input.value should not, if this is not equal to my password, remember my password is 2456, and I've also declared my input.value. This input, the values that are in the input. Okay, so now if the input.value is equal to the password, and the input.value.length is greater than or equal to 4, then all this should run. So this is when you get the password. So I'm saying the input.value should be cleared, and the change, which is this text dot style dot display, should be none. So whenever I do 2, 4, 5, 6, then I click OK, then it alerts, then the entire text disappears because we've already entered the text and we got it. Moving on, I have another if statement here. So now I'm saying if the input.value.length is greater than or equal to 4, and I should have come up to a better variable name. So inu is I'm referencing this variable here that I've said if the input.value, if it is not equal to my password variable, which is this up here, which is 2456. So now if the input.length dot variable dot length is greater than or equal to 4, and it is not equal to my password, I want the change dot style dot display to be equal to block. Then I want the change dot style dot text content, which is a way of changing the content of the p tag or element. So notice here I'm using the backtick. I'm using backtick here, which is a new way of writing a string, which is called template string. So I'm saying input pin enter. So whenever you input something that is wrong, that is not the password, it is a incorrect pin entered. So I'm also clearing the values on the in the input field. So else, so if this condition here is wrong, I want the input dot value should it should be equal to the text content. Moving on, I have, remember I targeted the delete button here using this variable. I targeted the button with an ID of delete or del. So I'm saying I'm adding an event listener to that button. So I'm saying when there's a click, then this function should run. So whenever the function runs, I want whatever value that is in the input tag or element to be cleared. I want it to be an empty string. So whenever I input something here and I click on the clear button, which has the input, which has the delete ID. So whenever I click on it, I want the input dot value to be cleared. So let's say, okay, this is the password I typed and I know that it is wrong. Then I click clear so I can type all over again. So now moving on, I'm also targeting the okay ID. So I'm adding an event listener to it. So whenever I click on it, I want the function to run. The function is also going to clear the input dot value to make it an empty string. So what I'm simply saying is that whenever I type the password 2456, then I say okay, it says welcome correct password, and when I say okay, it clears the input. Remember, we've written this function to check if the password is correct or not. So that is basically all for the JavaScript section. So now, how did I make this fun design, or how did I implement what we've done here to this fun design? So now, here is the markup of the fun design. If you really want to know how I made the fun design, please check out my old video. I'm not going to be going over this all over again. So here is my fun design markup. So basically all I did was to change the data attributes in my object. So looking at the location of my file here, so in this folder, there's a file named index.html. So this file, I'm accessing it through my object tag or element, through the data attributes. So saying, load this file here. So I'm saying load this file which belongs to the phone password. So I know it's complicated, and well, it's not that complicated. If you have questions, you can always leave them in the description, in the comments below, and I'll answer them. So that's basically all. So when you watch how I did the phone design, you would understand it. And I can click on the power off button, changes to power on, and this overlay comes on, and so on like that. So that will be all for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, and if you've watched it to the end, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the future. Bye bye.